Genetics is a science with a great deal of promise. It deals with the transfer of biological information from cell to cell, from parents to offspring, and thus from generation to generation. Genetics is the branch of biology that is concerned with heredity and variation. It deals with the physical and chemical nature of the passing of information from generation to generation. The first observations which led to genetics focused on why children resembled their parents more than the other members of the population. Take for example, my parents resemble my grandparents and I resemble my parents. My child resembles me more than his cousin. It is a general observation that offspring resemble their parents. The transmission of characters from generation to generation, that is from parents to offspring, is called inheritance or heredity. Now, the question that arises is why? Why do I resemble my parents and how? Surely, there must be something that transmits characteristics between generations. Somehow, the body knows and remembers the characteristics of the parent. Something in my body carries a remnant of my parents. This is what is called a gene. Now, let us take an example. I am a product of my parents. I have the characteristics of my mother as well as father. My mother resembles her mother and father. My maternal grandmother and grandfather. My father resembles his father and mother. My paternal grandmother and grandfather. My maternal grandfather has many similarities with my maternal great-grandparents and so on. Let us say I belong to generation X. My parents are generation X minus 1. Their parents or my grandparents are generation X minus 1 minus 1, that is X minus 2. And their parents, my great grandparents, are generation X minus 2 minus 1, that is X minus 3. Now, if we compare two continuous generations, say generation X and generation X minus 1, the similarities are greater than the dissimilarities. What if we take generation X minus 2 and generation X minus 3? We will still find that these generations have a lot of similarities. Dissimilarities are rare. Two continuous generations, hence, exhibit a significant continuity in their characteristics. Now, let us take two discontinuous generations. In other words, there is a gap between them. If we compare generation X with generation X minus 3, the dissimilarities are greater in comparison to the previous example where we considered continuous generations. In a jump of four generations, the differences have turned out to be greater than a jump of one generation. This is reflected in real life also. I reflect most of the characteristics of my father and mother. But do I have that much in common with my great-great-grandparents? Probably a bit lesser. But we still have a lot in common. This implies that when we compare two immediate generations, similarities are greater and gradually the differences increase when we compare generations that are further apart. The occurrence of differences among the individuals of the same species is called variation. What if we compare generation X with generation X minus N? The greater the value of N, the more pronounced the differences will be. So, when in nature we compare the generation X with the generation X minus 10,000, we could find quite a lot of stark differences. In fact, the differences might be greater than the similarities. The word genetics was coined in 1906 to designate the new science of heredity. In 1910, Mendelian genetics fused with the chromosomal theory of inheritance, giving rise to today's classical genetics. About half a century before the term was coined, Johann Mendel, the young son of an Austrian farmer, wanted to get an education, but his family could not afford it. Monastic life ensured that he could do away with the perpetual anxiety about a means of livelihood and would not have to pay for his education himself. He was given the name Gregor upon entering priesthood. His professors, including agricultural scientist Johann Karl Nessler, who had conducted extensive research of hereditary traits of plants and animals, and physicist Frederick Franz, who provided him with the latest scientific research, and some of his colleagues encouraged Mendel to study variation. Mendel began his studies in 1856 in the 2-acre garden of his monastery. For 7 consecutive years, Mendel conducted hybridization experiments in his meticulous manner. He designed the necessary experiments, counted and classified the peas resulting from his crosses, compared the proportions with mathematical models, and formulated a hypothesis for these differences. Mendel considered 7 distinct characteristics of the pea plant. Each of these distinguishable characteristics is called a trait. For example, the height of a plant is a particular trait. Mendel was not the first to perform these experiments, but he was one of the first to consider the results in terms of individual traits. In 1866, Mendel published his research. In his work, he mentioned invisible factors. According to Mendel, each factor determined the expression of a trait. Later, Johansen borrowed the term gene from Darwin's usage pangene. He used it in place of Mendel's factors. This is the word we know and use today. The hereditary units, which are transmitted from one generation to the next, are called genes. For example, in our case, that is in humans, genes not only determine what we look like but also influence our behavior, personalities, susceptibility, aging processes, and indeed longevity. They influence everything. Back to Mendel's pea plants, he observed that genes remain in pairs. Continuing from our previous example, height of the plant can be tall or dwarf. The view of paired genes was supported by Bateson, who subsequently renamed it to allelomorphs and further shortened it to allele. Alternative forms of a gene are called alleles. They can be just 2, as in the case of plant height, or they can be a lot more. Alleles are used to control different alternative traits. What is interesting is that starting from a bacterium all the way up to Homo sapiens, there always seem to be at least 2 distinct forms of every gene. The science of genetics often reveals such remarkable truths. In the next part, we will discuss in detail about genes, chromosomes, and DNA. See you on the other end.